This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A tram, also known as tramcar, and in North America known as streetcar, trolley or trolley car, is a rail vehicle which runs on tracks along public urban streets, and also sometimes on a segregated right-of-way. The lines or networks operated by tramcars are called tramways. Tramways powered by electricity, the most common type historically, were once called electric street railways, mainly in the USA. However, trams were widely used in urban areas before the universal adoption of electrification. Other methods of powering trams are listed below under history. Tram lines may also run between cities and or towns, for example, interurbans, tram-train, and or partially grade separated even in the city's light rail very occasionally. Trams also carry freight. Tram vehicles are usually lighter and shorter than conventional trains and rapid transit trains, but the size of trams, particularly light rail vehicles, is rapidly increasing. Some trams, for instance tram-trains, may also run on ordinary railway tracks. A tramway may be upgraded to a light rail or a rapid transit line. Two urban tramways may be connected to an interurban, etc. For all these reasons, the differences between the various modes of rail transportation are often indistinct in the United States. The term tram has sometimes been used for rubber-tired trackless trains, which are not related to the other vehicles covered in this article today. Most trams use electrical power, usually fed by an overhead pantograph, in some cases by a sliding shoe on a third rail, trolley pole or bow collector if necessary. They may have dual power systems. 33 articulated, 34 double-decker, 35 tram-train, 4 non-commuter, 41 cargo trams, 42 hearse trams, 43 dog car, 44 contractors mobile offices, 45 restaurant trams, 46 mobile library service, 47 nursery trams, 48 specialized work trams, 49 advertising, 410 tourist trams, 5 tramway operation, 51 tram stop, 52 controls, 53 track, 54 power supply, 6 tram and light rail transit systems around the world, 61 statistics, 62 popularity, 63 major tram systems, 64 Africa, 65 Asia, 66 Europe, 67 North America, 68 Oceania, 69 South America, 7 advantages, 8 disadvantages, 9 in popular culture, 91 in literature, 92 in music, 93 in the visual arts, 94 in drama, 95 in film, 96 ballets, 97 operas, 98 on television, 99 other. 10 notable incidents involving trams, 11 scale modeling of trams, 12 types, 13 regional, 14 see also, 15 references, 16 further reading, 17 external links. Etymology and terminology. The English terms tram and tramway are derived from the Scots word tram, referring respectively to a type of truck, goods wagon or freight railroad car used in coal mines, and the tracks on which they ran. The word tram probably derived from Middle Flemish tramé, beam, handle of a barrow, bar, rung, a Romanesque word meaning the beam or shaft of a barrow or sledge. Also the barrow itself, the identical word la tramé with the meaning crossbeam, is also used in the French language. Etymologists believe that the word tram refers to the wooden beams the railway tracks were initially made of before the railroad pioneers switched to the much more wear-resistant tracks made of iron and, later, steel. The word tram car is attested from 1873. Although the terms tram and tramway have been adopted by many languages, they are not used universally in English. North Americans prefer streetcar, trolley, or trolley car. The term streetcar is first recorded in 1840, and originally referred to horse cars when electrification came. Americans began to speak of trolley cars or later. Trolleys, a widely held belief, holds the word to derive from the troller, said to derive from the words traveler and roller, a four-wheeled device that was dragged along dual overhead wires by a cable that connected the troller to the top of the car and collected electrical power from the overhead wires. This portmanteau derivation is, however, most likely folk etymology. Trolley and variants refer to the verb troll, meaning roll, and probably derived from Old French, and cognate uses of the word were well established for handcarts and horse drayage, as well as for nautical uses. The troller design frequently fell off the wires, and was soon replaced by other more reliable devices. The trolley pole and notably the bow collector both were fitted to the top of the car and were spring-loaded in order to keep, respectively, a small trolley wheel or grooved lubricated skate mounted at the top of the pole or a steel rod forming the top of the bow firmly in contact with the underside of the overhead wire. The terms trolley pole and trolley wheel both derive from the troller trams using trolley pole current collection are normally powered through a single pole, with return current earthed through the steel wheels and rails, though some systems, e.g. parts of the London system, used twin overhead wires and poles to avoid the effects of stray currents flowing through the earth. Modern trams often have an overhead pantograph mechanical link to connect to power, abandoning the trolley pole altogether. The alternative North American term trolley may strictly speaking be considered incorrect, as the term can also be applied to cable cars, or conduit cars that instead draw power from an underground supply. Conventional diesel tourist buses decorated to look like streetcars are sometimes called trolleys in the U.S. tourist trolley, furthering confusion. The term tram has instead been applied to open-sided, low-speed segmented vehicles on rubber tires generally used to ferry tourists short distances, for example on the Universal Studios backlot tour, and, in many countries, as tourist transport to major destinations. The term may also apply to an aerial ropeway, e.g. the Roosevelt Island Tramway. Over time, the term trolley has fallen into informal use, and may be applied loosely to a wide variety of different vehicle types. The word has taken on a historic or picturesque connotation, and is often associated with tourist or leisure travel in North America. Professional or formal documents generally use more precise alternative terms, such as streetcar or light rail vehicle LRV. Although the use of the term trolley for tram was not adopted in Europe, the term was later associated with the trolleybus, a rubber-tired vehicle running on hard pavement, which draws its power from pairs of overhead wires. These electric buses, which use twin trolley poles, are also called trackless trolleys, particularly in the northeastern U.S., or sometimes simply trolleys in the U.K., as well as in Seattle and Vancouver. History main article, History of Trams. Horse-drawn main article, Horsecar. The Welsh Swansea and Mumbles Railway ran the world's first passenger tram service. The very first tram was on the Swansea and Mumbles Railway in South Wales, UK. It was horse-drawn at first, and later moved by steam and electric power. The Mumbles Railway Act was passed by the British Parliament in 1804, and the first tram similar to streetcars in the US some 30 years later started operating in 1807. External video clip from a Belfast horse tram in 1901 on YouTube. The first streetcars, also known as horsecars in North America, were built in the United States and developed from city stagecoach lines and omnibus lines that picked up and dropped off passengers on a regular route without the need to be pre-hired. These trams were an animal railway, usually using teams of horses and sometimes mules to haul the cars, usually two as a team. Occasionally other animals were put to use, or humans in emergencies. The first streetcar line, developed by Irish-born John Stevenson, was the New York and Harlem Railroad's 4th Avenue line, which ran along the Bowery and 4th Avenue in New York City. Service began in 1832. It was followed in 1835 by New Orleans, Louisiana, which has the oldest continuously operating street railway system in the world. According to the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, in other world regions, the first tramway systems, all horse-drawn, were Continental Europe, 1839 MONTBRISON to Montrond, France; South America, 1858 Santiago, Chile; Africa, 1860 Alexandria, Egypt; Oceania, 1860 Sydney, Australia; Asia, 1869 Batavia, now Jakarta; Netherlands; East Indies, now Indonesia. In many cases, these early forms of public transport developed out of industrial haulage. Routes are from the omnibus that first ran on public streets, using the newly invented iron or steel rail or tramway. These were local versions of the stagecoach lines and picked up and dropped off passengers on a regular route, without the need to be pre-hired. Horsecars on tramlines were an improvement over the omnibus, as the low rolling resistance of metal wheels on iron or steel rails, usually grooved from 1852 on, allowed the animals to haul a greater load for a given effort than the omnibus and gave a smoother ride. The horse-drawn streetcar combined the low cost, flexibility, and safety of animal power with the efficiency, smoothness, and all-weather capability of a railway. In Australia, there were horse-drawn lines or systems in Adelaide, Saw, Ballarat, Victoria, Brisbane, Queensland, Gawler, Saw, Perth, Waa, Sydney, NSW, Victor Harbour, Saw, the latter reconstructed and operating as a tourist heritage line. Steam main article, tram engine. Steam hauled tram in Italy. C. 1890s. The first mechanical trams were powered by steam generally generally, there were two types of steam tram. The first and most common had a small steam locomotive called a tram engine in the UK at the head of a line of one or more carriages, similar to a small train systems. With such steam trams included Christchurch, New Zealand, Sydney, Australia, other city systems in New South Wales, Munich, Germany from August 1883 on, British India, Pakistan from 1885, and the Dublin. Main article, cable car railway. A San Francisco cable car, a cable-pulled system, still operating as of 2015. The next motive system for trams was the cable car, which was pulled along a fixed track by a moving steel cable. The power to move the cable was normally provided at a powerhouse site a distance away from the actual vehicle. The first practical cable car line was tested in San Francisco in 1873. Part of its success is attributed to the development of an effective and reliable cable grip mechanism to grab and release the moving cable without damage. The second city to operate cable trams was Dunedin in New Zealand, from 1881 to 1957. From 1885 to 1940, the city of Melbourne, Victoria, Australia operated one of the largest cable systems in the world, at its peak running 592 trams on 75 kilometers 47. 1906 in Dresden, Germany. In 1901, an elevated suspended cable car following the Eugen Langen one-railed floating tram system started operating. Cable cars operated on Highgate Hill in North London and Kennington to Brixton Hill in South London. They also worked around Upper Douglas in the Isle of Man from 1897 to 1929. Cable car 72 73rds is the sole survivor of the Fleet cable tram dummy and trailer on the St Kilda line in Melbourne in 1905. Cable cars suffered from high infrastructure costs, since an expensive system of cables, pulleys, stationary engines and lengthy underground vault structures beneath the rails had to be provided. They also required physical strength and skill to operate, and alert operators to avoid obstructions and other cable cars. The cable had to be disconnected, dropped at designated locations to allow the cars to coast by inertia. For example, when crossing another cable line, the cable would then have to be picked up to resume progress, the whole operation requiring precise timing to avoid damage to the cable and the grip mechanism. Breaks and frays in the cable, which occurred frequently, required the complete cessation of services over a cable route while the cable was repaired due to overall wear. The entire length of cable, typically several kilometers, would have to be replaced on a regular schedule. After the development of reliable electrically powered trams, the costly high-maintenance cable car systems were rapidly replaced in most locations. Cable cars remained especially effective in hilly cities, since their non-driven wheels would not lose traction as they climbed or descended a steep hill. The moving cable would physically pull the car up the hill at a steady pace. Unlike a low-powered steam or horse-drawn car, cable cars do have wheel brakes and track brakes, but the cable also helps restrain the car to going downhill at a constant speed. Performance in steep terrain partially explains the survival of cable cars in San Francisco. However, the extensive cable car system of Chicago operated over a large, relatively flat area. The San Francisco cable cars, though significantly reduced in number, continue to perform a regular transportation function. In addition to being a well-known tourist attraction, a single cable line also survives in Wellington, New Zealand, rebuilt in 1979 as a funicular but still called the Wellington cable car. A third system, actually two separate cable lines with a shared power station in the middle, operates from the Welsh town of Llandudno up to the top of the Great Orme Hill in North Wales. UK hybrid funicular electric former second generation cable tractor, used between 1978 and 2005, assisting a tramcar on the cable section of the Opicina tramway in Trieste, Italy. The Opicina tramway in Trieste operates a hybrid funicular electric system. Conventional electric trams are operated in street running and on reserved track for most of their route. However, on one steep segment of track, they are assisted by cable tractors, which push the trams uphill and act as brakes for the downhill run for safety. The cable tractors are always deployed on the downhill side of the tram vehicle. Similar systems were used elsewhere in the past, notably on the Queen Anne Counterbalance in Seattle and the Darling Street Wharf line in Sydney. Electric trolley cars. Main article, history of electric trams. Lichterfeld tram, 1882. Historic German electric tram. Electric trams were first experimentally installed in St. Petersburg, Russia, invented and tested by Fyodor Perotsky as early as 1880. These trams, like virtually all others mentioned in this section, used either a trolley pole or a pantograph to feed power from electric wires strung above the tram route. Nevertheless, there were early experiments with battery-powered trams, but these appear to have all been unsuccessful. The first trams in Bendigo, Australia, in 1892, were battery-powered powered, but within as little as 3 months they were replaced with horse-drawn trams in New York City. Some minor lines also used storage batteries then. Comparatively recently, during the 1950s, a longer battery-operated tramway line ran from Milan to Bergamo in China. There is a Nanjing battery tram line and has been running since 2014. The first regular electric tram service using pantographs or trolley poles, the Gross-Lichterfeld tramway, was put into service in Lichterfeld, then a suburb of Berlin, now part of the southwestern Berlin city district of Steglitz-Zehlendorf, by Siemens. Electric tramway in the world. The first tram for permanent service with overhead lines was the Modeling and Hinterbrühl tram in Austria. It began operating in October 1883, but was closed in 1932. Multiple functioning experimental electric trams were exhibited at the 1884 World Cotton Centennial World's Fair in New Orleans, Louisiana, but they were not deemed good enough to replace the Lamb fireless engines that then propelled the St. Charles Avenue streetcar in that city in the United States. Electric trams were first tested in service in Richmond, Virginia, in 1888, in the Richmond Union Passenger Railway built by Frank J. Sprague, though the first commercial installation of an electric streetcar in the United States was built in 1884 in Cleveland, Ohio, and operated for a period of 1 year by the East Cleveland Street Railway Company double-decker tram in Blackpool. The first electric street tramway in Britain, the Blackpool Tramway, was opened on 29 September 1885 using conduit collection along Blackpool Promenade. Since the closure of the Glasgow Corporation Tramways in 1962, this has been the only first-generation operational tramway in the UK, and is still in operation in a modernised form. Sarajevo built a city-wide system of electric trams in 1885. Budapest established its tramway system in 1887, and its ring line has grown to be the busiest tram line in Europe, with a tram running every 60 seconds at rush hour. However, Istanbul's line T1, with a minimum headway of 2 minutes, probably carries more passengers. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, a number of systems in various parts of the world employed trams powered by gas, naphtha gas or coal gas. In particular, gas trams are known to have operated between Alphington and Clifton Hill in the northern suburbs of Melbourne, Australia, 1886-1888, in Berlin and Dresden, Germany, in Estonia 1920s-1930, between Jelenia Góra, Czepłice, and Sobieszów in Poland from 1897, and in the UK at Lytham St. Anne's, Neath 1896-1920, and Trafford Park, Manchester 1897-1908. On 29 December 1886, the Melbourne newspaper The Argus reprinted a report from the San Francisco Bulletin that Mr. Noble had demonstrated a new motor car for tramways with success. The tramcar, exactly similar in size, shape, and capacity to a cable grip car, had the motive power of gas, with which the reservoir is to be charged once a day at power stations by means of a rubber hose. The car also carried an electricity generator for lighting up the tram and also for driving the engine on steep grades and effecting a start. Comparatively little has been published about gas trams, however. Research on the subject was carried out for an article in the October 2011 edition of The Times, the historical journal of the Australian Association of Timetable Collectors, now the Australian Timetable Association. A tram system powered by compressed natural gas was due to open in Malaysia in 2012, but as of 2016 there was no evidence of anything having happened. News about the project appears to have dried up. Other power sources. The only petrol-driven tram of Stockholm Sparviger, on Line 19 in the 1920s. In some places, other forms of power were used to power the tram Hastings and some other tramways, for example Stockholm Sparviger in Sweden and some lines in Karachi, used petrol trams. Paris operated trams that were powered by compressed air using the Makarsky system. Galveston Island Trolley in Texas operated diesel trams due to the city's hurricane-prone location, which would result in frequent damage to an electrical supply system. Although Portland, Victoria promotes its tourist tram as being a cable car, it actually operates using a hidden diesel motor. The tram, which runs on a circular route around the town of Portland, uses dummies, grip cars and saloon trailer cars formerly used on the extensive Melbourne cable tramway system and now beautifully restored in March 2015. China South Rail Corporation CSR demonstrated the world's first hydrogen fuel cell vehicle tramcar at an assembly facility in Qingdao. The chief engineer of the CSR subsidiary CSR Safong Co. Ltd., Liang Jianying, said that the company is studying how to reduce the running costs of the tram designed single-ended versus double-ended. A tram with double-ended features in Warsaw, Poland. A double-ended tram has an operator's cab and controls at each end of the vehicle, which allows it to easily be driven at full speed in either direction on a continuous segment of track. Typically at the end of a run, the tram's operator will walk from one end of the tram to the other, and then commence the tram route in the other direction. The tram is usually switched to another track by use of crossover points or Y-points. Conversely, a single-ended vehicle needs a method of turning at termini so that the operator's cab is in the front of the tram for the reverse journey. This usually necessitates a turning loop or triangle. On the other hand, the single cab and controls and fewer door spaces make the tram lighter, increases passenger accommodation including many more seats, and affects reductions in equipment, weight, first cost, maintenance cost, and operating expense. A single-ended tram has operator's controls at only one end, and can safely be driven at speed in the forward direction but is also capable of reverse movement, typically at slower speed, using a small set of controls at the rear. The configuration of the doors is usually asymmetrical, favoring the side expected to be closest to the street curb and footpath at the end of a run. The tram must be turned around via a balloon loop or some other method, to face in the opposite direction for a return trip. Two single-ended trams with doors on both sides may be coupled into a semi permanently. Coupled married pair or twinset, with operator's controls at each end of the combination. Such a setup is operated as if it were a double-ended tram, except that the operator must exit one vehicle and enter the other, when reversing at the end of the run. In addition, if overhead electrical power is fed from a trolley pole, the direction of the trolley pole must be reversed at the end of the run, to ensure that the pole is pulled behind or trailing the vehicle, to avoid dewiring. This was achieved by a member of the crew swinging the pole through 180 degrees if there was only one pole, or lowering one pole and raising the other if there were two. More commonly nowadays, a bidirectional pantograph may be used to feed power, eliminating the need for an extra procedure when reversing direction. Low floor. For more details on this topic, see low floor tram. Two trams in Braunschweig, Germany. The left one is a 1981 high floor tram, the right one a 2007 low floor from around the 1990s. Light rail vehicles not made for the occasional high platform light rail system have usually been of partial or full low floor design, with the floor 300 to 360. Provide access to disabled passengers without using expensive wheelchair lifts, while at the same time making boarding faster and easier for other passengers. Entirely low-floor Škoda Forcity in Prague. Various companies have developed particular low-floor designs, varying from part low-floor with internal steps between the low-floor section and the high-floor sections over the bogies, e.g. Citytram and Siemens S70, to 100% low-floor, where the floor passes through a corridor between the drive wheels, thus maintaining a relatively constant steepless level from end to end of the tram. Prior to the introduction of the Škoda Forcity, this carried the mechanical penalty of requiring bogies to be fixed and unable to pivot except for less than 5 degrees in some trams, and thus reducing curve negotiation. This creates undue wear on the tracks and wheels. Passengers appreciate the ease of boarding and alighting from low-floor trams and moving about inside 100% low-floor trams. Passenger satisfaction with low-floor trams is high. Low-floor trams are now running in many cities around the world, including Adelaide, Amsterdam, Bratislava, Dublin, Gold Coast, Helsinki, Hiroshima, Houston, Istanbul, Melbourne, Milan, Prague, Riga, Strasbourg, Sydney, Vienna, Zagreb and Zurich. Low-floor tram made in Ukraine, Electron T5L64 on streets of Lviv. Ultra-low-floor. Main article, ultra-low-floor. A type B ULF tram in Vienna. The ultra-low-floor or ULF tram is a type of low-floor tram operating in Vienna, Austria as of 1997, and in Oradea, Romania, with the lowest floor height of any such vehicle. In contrast to other low-floor trams, the floor in the interior of ULF is at sidewalk height about 18. Articulation is normally suspended between carbody sections in the Škoda Forcity, which is the world's first 100% low-floor tram with pivoting bogies. A Jacobs bogie supports the articulation between the two or more carbody sections. An articulated tram may be low-floor variety or high regular floor variety. Newer model trams may be up to 72 meters 236. Tram-train. Main article, tram-train. Tram-train operation uses vehicles such as the Flexity Link and Regio Cities, which are suited for use on urban tram lines and also meet the necessary indication, power, and strength requirements for operation on mainline railways. This allows passengers to travel from suburban areas into city center destinations without having to change from a train to a tram. It has been primarily developed in Germanic countries, in particular Germany and Switzerland. Karlsruhe is a notable pioneer of the tram-train tram-train non-commuter cargo trams cargo tram run by Volkswagen in Dresden, Germany on a section of grass track. It delivers parts to the transparent factory. Since the 19th century, goods have been carried on rail vehicles through the streets, often near docks and steelworks, for example the Weymouth Harbour Tramway in Weymouth, Dorset. Belgian vicinal tramway routes were used to haul agricultural produce, timber and coal from Blaney Colliery, while several of the U.S. interurbans carried freight in Australia. Three different freight cars operated in Melbourne between 1927 and 1977, and the city of Kislovodsk in Russia had a freight-only tram system consisting of one line, which was used exclusively to deliver bottled Narzan mineral water to the railway station. Today, the German city of Dresden has a regular cargo tram service, run by the world's longest tram trainsets, 594 meters 195. On weekdays, trams are planned to make four deliveries per hour between 7. Dog car in Melbourne. A dog car was used between 1937 and 1955 for transporting dogs and their owners to the Royal Melbourne Showgrounds Contractors Mobile Offices. Two former passenger cars from the Melbourne system were converted and used as mobile offices within the Preston workshops between 1969 and 1974, by personnel from Commonwealth Engineering and ASEA, who were connected with the construction of Melbourne's Z-Class Cars Restaurant Trams. A Melbourne tramcar restaurant in St Kilda. A number of systems have introduced restaurant trams, particularly as a tourist attraction. This is specifically a modern trend. Systems which have or have had restaurant trams include Adelaide, Bendigo and Melbourne, in Australia, Brussels in Belgium, The Hague in the Netherlands, Christchurch in New Zealand, Milan, Rome and Turin in Italy, Moscow, Russia, Almaty, Kazakhstan and Zurich, Switzerland. Restaurant trams are particularly popular in Melbourne, where three of the iconic W-class trams have been converted. All three often run in tandem, and there are usually multiple meal sittings bookings, often close months in advance. Bistro trams with buffets operated between Krefeld and Dusseldorf in Germany, while Helsinki in Finland has a pub tram. Frankfurt, Germany has a tourist circle line called Ebelwei Express, in which the traditional local drink Apfelwein, locally called Ebelwei, a type of hard cider, is served. Mobile library service Munich tram number 24, delivered in 1912, was refurbished as a mobile library in 1928 known as Statische Wanderbücherei München. It was in public service until 1970. It was preserved and is now on public display in a railway museum in Hanover, Edmonton. Alberta used a streetcar bookmobile from 1941 to 1956. Nursery trams. After World War II, in both Warsaw and Wrocław, Poland, so-called trams nurseries were in operation, collecting children from the workplaces of their parents, often tram employees. These mobile nurseries either carried the children around the system or delivered them to the nursery school run by transport company specialized work trams. Most systems had cars that were converted to specific uses on the system, other than simply the carriage of passengers. As just one example, the Melbourne system used or uses the following technical cars: conductors and or drivers instruction cars, a laboratory testing car, a line marking car, a pantograph testing car, per way locomotives, rail grinders, a rail hardener loco, a scrapper car, scrubbers, sleeper carriers, track cleaners, a welding car, a wheel transport car and a workshops locomotive advertising. Many systems have passenger carrying vehicles with all over advertising on the exterior and or the interior. Tourist trams. Many systems have retained historical trams which will often run over parts of the system for tourists and or tram enthusiasts. In Melbourne, Australia, a number of the iconic W-class run throughout each day in a set route which circles the central business district. They are primarily for the use of tourists, although often also used by regular commuters. Tramway operation. Vasilyostrovsky Tram Depot and Museum of Electrical Transport in St. Petersburg, Russia. There are two main types of tramways: the classic tramway built in the early 20th century with the tram system operating in mixed traffic, and the later type which is most often associated with the tram system having its own right-of-way. Tram systems that have their own right-of-way are often called light rail, but this does not always hold true, though these two systems differ in their operation. Their equipment is much the same. Engineers working on an electro-mechanical bogie from a tram at Krych Tramway Village. Tram stop. Main article: tram stop. Tram stops may be similar to bus stops in design and use, particularly in street running sections, where in some cases other vehicles are legally required to stop clear of the tram doors. Some stops may resemble to railway platforms, particularly in private right-of-way sections. sections and where trams are boarded at standard railway platform height, as opposed to using steps at the doorway or low-floor trams controls. Trams were traditionally operated with separate levers for applying power and brakes. More modern vehicles use a locomotive-style controller which incorporate a dead man's switch. The success of the PCC streetcar had also seen trams use automobile-style foot controls, allowing hands-free operation, particularly when the driver was responsible for fare collection. Track main article, tramway track. Tramway track can have different rail profiles to accommodate the various operating environments of the vehicle. They may be embedded into concrete for street running operation, or use standard ballasted track with railroad ties on high-speed sections. A more ecological solution is to embed tracks into grass turf power supply. Electric trams use various devices to collect power from overhead lines. The most common device found today is the pantograph, while some older systems use trolley poles or bow collectors. Ground-level power supply has become a recent innovation. Another new technology uses supercapacitors. When an insulator at a track switch cuts off power from the tram for a short distance along the line, the tram can use energy stored in a large capacitor to drive the tram past the gap in the power feed. A rather obsolete system for power supply is conduit current collection. Tram and light rail transit systems around the world. Main articles, tram and light rail transit systems and list of tram and light rail transit systems. Czech Tatra T314,113 units sold worldwide make it one of the highest selling types of tram throughout the world. There are many tram systems, some dating from the late 19th or early 20th centuries. However, a large number of the old systems were closed during the mid-20th century because of such perceived drawbacks as route inflexibility and maintenance expense. This was especially the case in North American, Australian, British, French, and other West European cities. Some traditional tram systems did, however, survive and remain operating much as when first built over a century ago. In the past 20 years, their numbers have been augmented by modern tramway or light rail systems in cities that had discarded this form of transport. Statistics: tram and light rail systems operate in 388 cities across the world, 206 of which are in Europe. Since 1985-120 light rail systems have opened, since 2078 systems have opened, while 13 have closed. The countries that have opened the most systems since 2000 are the USA 23, France 20, Spain 16, and Turkey 8, 15,618. St. Petersburg 312 meters, and Vienna 305 meters. The most intensely used networks passengers per kilometer of per year are Istanbul, Hong Kong, Tokyo, and Sarajevo. Just over 36,000 trams and light rail vehicles are in operation. The largest fleets are in Prague 920, Moscow 919, St. Petersburg 833, Budapest 612, and Warsaw 526. Between 1997 and 2014, 400 to 450 vehicles have been built per year. Source: as of October 2015, popularity. Tramways with tramcars, British English, or street railways with streetcars. North American English were common throughout the industrialized world in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, but they had disappeared from most British, Canadian, French, and U.S. cities by the mid-20th century. By contrast, trams in parts of continental Europe continued to be used by many cities, although there were contractions in some countries, including the Netherlands. Since 1980, trams have returned to favor in many places, partly because their tendency to dominate the roadway, formerly seen as a disadvantage, is now considered to be a merit. New systems have been built in the United States, Great Britain, Ireland, France, Australia, and many other countries. In Milan, Italy, the old Ventado trams are considered by its inhabitants a symbol of the city. The same can be said of trams in Melbourne in general, but particularly the iconic W-class. The Toronto streetcar system had similarly become an iconic symbol of the city, operating the largest network in the Americas as well as the only large-scale tram system in Canada, not including light rail systems or heritage lines. Major tram systems: Melbourne tram network with proposals, extension Stadtbahn, Hanover, Rio de Janeiro. Tram map, 2009. The map is out of date for the Silvestre section, closed in 2008 or earlier. The largest tram: classic tram, streetcar, Strandbahn, and fast tram, light rail. Stadtbahn networks in the world by route length as of 2016 are Melbourne 256, 954, 704, or 78.